पग प्यारे दंगल 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 सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे दंगल 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 दंगल. Great morning, my dear friends. Bhupesh Anand this side again. So today we will be starting with discounted cash flow application, a new reading in from quantitative methods. But this reading is very, very important from examination point of view and for real life point of view. So discounted cash flow application, please mark a 5-star in this. And there are 6 learning outcomes involved in this. So it no doubt it is a very short, a smaller reading, but is of very huge importance. And I have written some words. Be aware of your thoughts, because thoughts will become your words. There is an important saying that we should be aware of our thoughts, because that thoughts will become the words. And be aware of your words, because that will become your actions. And be aware of your actions, because that will become your habits. And be aware of your habits, because that will change your destiny. So all the work, you know, started from thoughts. So when you think that you have to pass in the CFA level 1 examination, you will. And all the other environment will automatically change. So let's start with the journey. What are those 6 learning outcomes? Please take out your registers and calculator, because we will be doing some case studies on the basis of which I will be telling you how to calculate, how to use a cash flow function row. Earlier in the last reading, time value of money, we discussed about TVM row. We discussed about so many other functions in the calculator. So today I will be telling you the most important row, that is cash flow row, NPV function and IRR function, how it can be used from the help of a calculator. Within seconds, you can calculate NPV. And what is NPV? So learning outcome number A is there in my reading, CFA level 1 curriculum, that please calculate and interpret. The first learning outcome is calculate and interpret NPV and IRR. It means net present value and internal rate of return is to be calculated, and then it is to be computed, and then it is to be interpreted. So today's lecture will be devoted on this learning outcome number A, and then we will be discussing the learning outcome number B, that why there is a difference, you know, there is a default, there is a conflict between the decision as per NPV and the decision as per IRR. Why there is a conflict in the decisions between two tools, and which tool is the best in deciding capital weighting decisions. There are 6 learning outcomes, and learning outcome number C, D, E and F relates to return. For example, learning outcome number C, we'll be discussing with holding period return. It is somewhat similar to portfolio, which we have discussed. Learning outcome number D, calculate and compare. Money weighted rate of return and time weighted rate of return. Money weighted and time weighted. Money weighted rate of return and time weighted rate of return. And in learning outcome number E, we will be discussing with bank discount yield, holding yield, bond yield, cash yield, etc, etc, etc. And if I am given with one yield, then I can calculate other yields also. So 4 learning outcomes out of 6 relates to yields: holding period yield, money weighted yield, and time weighted yield. And then firstly, we will be starting with lecture number 1, learning outcome number 1A, that is calculate and interpret NPV and IRR. So I will be devoting 2-3 lectures on this learning outcome, because this is very important and we have already discussed in corporate finance. But still, I will be dealing with it, because obviously I have to complete in every learning outcome. So learning outcome, please take out your registers, my dear sir, and please start writing down calculate and interpret NPV and IRR, and how we can make a decision on the basis of NPV and IRR. I have already told you, but still you have to write down. I know that you know, but you don't know that you don't know. Please write down NPV, net present value. As the name indicates, net present value. It means net means if plus minus the we do the plus and minus addition and subtraction, and the balancing figure is named as net. So that is net present value. When I say net present value, I mean present value of cash inflows, because in a project, in an investment, in a capital binding project, in any project, you know, there are two types of flows. One is cash outflow. Cash is going out. Cash is going out. And after future period, cash will come in. For example, you are doing CFL level 1 examination. You have already paid the fees to CFL level, to CFA Institute. That too in dollars. And you have paid me the fees by purchasing these video lectures. Now this is outflow. Outflow is generally at the zero period of time. In the beginning, I can say. In the beginning of the project. And when you will clear this examination, then you will get a job or you will start your own practice, and then you will get the cash flow, the salary or the client's fees, you know. That will be in future. So there are two types of flows. One is outflow and second is inflow in a capital budgeting process. In NPV, when we want to calculate, you know, there are two types of flows. So please, I will first point net present value of a project, or of a capital budgeting decision, or of a capital budgeting process or a project, present value of expected cash inflows. Present value of, I repeat the golden words, present value of expected. Expected means future, which I will be getting from present value of expected cash inflows. If I start with this project, how much inflow I will be getting in future minus present value of cash outflows, expected outflows. Supposingly I want to start with this project, then how much will be the outflow? How much will be the CFA Institute fees? How much will be the video lecture? How much time we have to devote? How much is the opportunity cost? And after doing this, after clearing the examination, how much will be the inflow in future? That will be coming to me. So all the figures are expected. So net present value is present value expected cash inflows of a project. Please write down along with me. Minus present value of expected outflows of the project. Sir, I know that you have already prepared a register separate for this quantitative methods, because this is the most important subject. And as per the timings, as per the marks weightage, 15% to 20% is there in your CFA level 1 examination, whether you're going for morning session or whether you're going for evening session. So please be attentive. Very important. Start doing the practice and do it along with me. So first point, following are the steps. Now these are the steps I have written, you know, for calculating NPV. We have discussed in corporate finance, but still, step number one is identify all the costs, that is all the outflows, and all the benefits, that is all cash inflows, in relation to a project. For example, you're doing a project of CFA. What are the costs? What are the fees I have to pay in all three levels? How much is the cost of the study material if I purchase it photocopied, or if I purchase original, if I purchase Quasar notes, if I purchase video lectures of Bhupesh Anand? How much will be the total cost? How much is the amount I have to pay for purchasing this financial calculator? And all that is named as cost. Then how much will be the benefit in future? Step number one. Step number two is, how much is the appropriate discounting rate? In the last reading, time value of money, we have discussed that interest rate, required rate of return, opportunity cost, discounting rate. As the name indicates, it is one of the same thing. What should be the discounting rate at which I should discount those future expected cash flows? Step number three, using the discounting rate, find present value. Now, using that discounting rate, you know, first point is we will calculating cash flows, cash outflows, then we will be finding out the appropriate discounting rate, which should be there applicable. And after that, we will be calculating the present value of that. And then last is calculate of NPV. We will be calculating the net present value. And when I say net present value, I mean, you know, there are so many different steps. Step one is identify all costs, this, and then using the discounting rate, compute NPV. And this point is very, very important, which I want to tell you, that before attempting any question of cash flow, I repeat, I repeat, in the time value of money reading also, I repeat that whenever you want to do time value of money, it is better to prepare a timeline. Then only you will be able to find out whether the question is asking about present value or future value, or whether it is ordinary annuity, whether it is annuity due, or whether, you know, frequency of compounding is how much, whether it is continuous compounding. It means all that confusion will be cleared by just preparing a timeline. And in main examination, even I have prepared in the morning session, in the evening session, that timeline, then only I will able to do it. So my request to you will be, please follow the same practice in cash flow also. So before attempting any step, it is advisable to prepare timeline CF1, CF2, CF3, CF4. It can be like this. You know, generally the positive we relate as cash inflows and negative we relate as cash outflows. So negative as cash outflows, positive as cash inflows. This is T0, this is T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, up to Tn. Or, you know, the pattern can be like this also, minus, plus, plus, it is, no need not to anybody. I will be telling you the tricks of a calculator with help of which you can calculate anything within seconds. So the point is, after calculating NPV, it is important to give the recommendation. Now, if NPV is positive, if NPV is positive, when present value of cash inflows will be more than present value of cash outflows, then it will be positive. And when, then it is better to accept the proposal. When present value of cash inflows are less than present value of cash outflows, it means NPV is negative. In that case, reject the proposal. In that case, reject the proposal. And if NPV is equal to zero, then present value of inflows is, it means present value of cash inflows is equal to present value of cash outflows. And then when it is a case, you know, some non-monetary factors are there which are to be taken into account before deciding the proposal. So let's start, you know, with a case study. I want to tell you all the concepts with the help of this case study. Even if you have not got anything up to this point, no issues. All the things will be cleared if you are very much attentive in coming 5 minutes. Please take out your calculators. I will be doing one case study along with you. I am giving you a project having this much outflow and these are the inflows. The life of the project is 4 years, the discounting rate is 40%. All that information I have given to you, and you have to calculate NPV of a project. Now, how to calculate NPV of a project with the help of a calculator, that again I will be telling you. So please write down this case study. Case study for understanding the concept of NPV. Following is the timeline. So in the question, I have given the timeline. In the question only, I have given the timeline which shows cash flows in relation to a project. If discounting rate is 40%, then calculate NPV and then recommend. So this is a timeline which is a part of a question, that in zero period, T0 minus 10,000, bracket means minus, and T1 I am given it 5,000, T2 5,000, T3 6,000, T4 6,000. So these are the inflows which are given to me. Discounting rate is 40% and I have to find out the NPV. Please take out your calculators. My dear friend, I will be telling you how with the help of a calculator you can solve it within seconds. Do not use time value. I have two or three methods to solve this, but I will be telling you the method which will play in long run, you know, and I will not be telling you 2-3 methods so that you will be confused in that which method is to use where. In discounted cash flow applications, you have to use cash flow function. In time value of money reading, you have to use TVM. So no doubt in this discounted cash flow also we can use TVM, but I will not be telling you those methods because it will rather confuse you. So please take out your calculators and you know, I will be using the cash flow function, the cash flow row, second row that I have just given to you, answer. Now, with the answer of this case study, I have given that any figure which is negative, we relate it as cash outflow. Anything which is positive, we relate it as cash inflow. So there are two types of flows, outflows and inflows. For example, just I have given the diagrammatic view of this timeline that 5,000 I will be getting as inflow in first year. When I say first year, it means end of the first year. When I say 5,000 in the second year, it means end of the second year. When I say 6,000 in the third year, it means end of the third year. Because if nothing is given by default, we always assume it is end. and again 6,000 the fourth year, end of the fourth year. Now, if I discount it, at T0, and if I calculate the net present value, that is present value, total of present value of all cash inflows of all 4 years, minus total of cash outflows, that is 10,000 at T0 or at any moment of time, you know. The balancing figure is named as net present value, and that net present value can be positive, can be negative. That I have already told you. So how to use a calculator? That is the main part which we have now. How to calculate the, you know, this with the help of a calculator. Even, you know, Google Baba also says that please use the calculator, you know, financial calculator, and then only we can easily do it. Now, how to do it? That I will be telling you. I have, you know, prepared all the different steps for you. Just see, there are no doubt different formulas and different concepts which are involved. But my dear sir, there is no need to do any formula. Only know these 3-4 functions of a cash flow. Then you can calculate IRR, you can calculate NPV, or any damn thing you want to calculate, you can calculate. Just see the steps which I have given to you. Now, the second row is starting from second button, which we have used in time value of money also. The second button in the second row is cash flow. It is not cash inflow or cash outflow, same. Cash inflow and outflow is same here. Cash flow, outflow we say it as minus, and our inflow we always say it as positive. The next button is NPV, net present value, which we want to calculate in this question. And the next button is IRR, that is internal rate of return. And then a arrow is there in case you want to delete. This is delete arrow, that is in case you want to delete anything, you can delete. So these are the 4 points which are given to you. Now, how to use a function, you know, how to use a calculator for this this NPV. So this cash flow function, I first have been pressing cash flow. Once I press cash flow in the screen, CFO 0 is coming there. Just see. Now, it can be there, you know, it can have up old work. So I have to firstly erase it. So second clear work. Now, it means old work which I have done at any time, moment of time, that has been erased now. Now, I am ready to start with the function, you know. So first step is press cash flow button, then second, then clear work, then CFO is coming on the screen. CFO is coming. It means how much is a cash flow of 0 period. Now, when I see the timeline, cash flow of 0 period is 10,000 negative. So I will be pressing 10,000, but because it is negative, so I will be pressing plus minus button, it comes to negative. I will be pressing enter, and then I will be pressing enter and downward arrow. I have written that 10,000 plus minus enter, enter, downward arrow. Then when I put downward arrow, the calculator is showing, telling me, please tell me on the screen, that's cash flow of first year, CO1. How much is the cash flow of first year? Now, I know that cash flow of first year is 5,000 and cash flow of second year is also 5,000. So, cash flow of first year is, I have to put 5,000. I have to do enter, then downward arrow. Then this calculator is asking me what is the frequency of that. It means whether you are getting cash flow of 5,000 only for first year, or also for second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, sixth year. That it means that is only for 1 year, or that is for more than 1 year. My dear friends, in the question, 5,000 is for first year as well as for second year. It means 5,000 I am getting for 2 years. So if 5,000 I am getting for 2 years, then I will put the frequency as 2. Now, this calculator will automatically recognize that cash flow in the first year is 5,000 and cash flow in the second year is 5,000. If you just change the frequency from 1 to 2, so I have written there, enter downward frequency is coming 2, because 5,000 is in year 1 as well as in year 2. So I am writing down 2, enter downward. Now, this calculator is asking for cash CO2. Now, actually it is CO3, but because CO1 we have given 2 frequencies, so automatically they will recognize it. Now, in third year, 6,000 is the cash inflow. Now in third year, 6,000 is the cash inflow. So I will be pressing 6,000, enter, downward arrow, downward arrow. Then again, this calculator is asking about what is the frequency, you know, whether 6,000 you are getting only for one time in third year or also in the fourth year, also in the fifth year, also in the sixth year. Now we know that 6,000 is being received in the third year as well as in the fourth year. So we will give frequency of 2. So now enter, I will be giving 2 frequency, enter downward arrow. Now this series will go on. Cash flow 3, cash flow 4 and 5. But we have only 4 and we have weeded 4 cash flows. So I will be pressing compute NPV. And then I will be pressing the button as NPV. Now once I press compute and NPV, calculator will say us that I cannot calculate NPV unless and until you tell me the discounting rate, the interest rate, the required rate, the opportunity rate. So first I have to compute, press compute and NPV, and then the calculator is asking about interest, and I have already told you that discounting rate is 40%, so I will be pressing 4040, enter. Once I put enter and downward arrow, automatically the NPV is coming, NPV 000. Now I have to just press the compute button because I want to compute NPV. Now NPV is coming in your screen, 129.11 minus. It means NPV is negative. It means the project is negative. It means the project should not be accepted. It means the inflows are less than outflows. So within seconds, we can calculate, you know, net present value. Hope you have enjoyed this lecture. In next lecture number 2, again, I will be telling you some concepts of NPV as well as we will be starting with IRR. Please do it along with me. It is an important chapter. Do the calculation steps which I have written for you. I have written the steps even, you know, that which buttons to be pressed, I have written that also. So please do it. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful, be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.